Douglas has long recommended that people who are serious about developing their own intuitive abilities first pay attention to their dreams and keep a dream journal like a diary. Since dreams dissipate from your normal waking memories so soon after you awaken, keep a small notebook and pen right by your bed. If you wake up from a dream, immediately turn to a blank page and write down your dream to the last detail you can remember, especially if you read something or heard someone say something in your dream. This kind of information can be especially meaningful. Dreams are deeply symbolic, and even though many times they may seem disjointed or nonsensical, they can be meaningful in many ways. Some might be meant to warn or alert you of future events that could be important to you. Some may reflect your physical, emotional, or spiritual state and attempt to guide you in a specific direction. Some are about your own subconscious desires. Others can be messages from those who have passed over or other beings in the spiritual realms. And of course, some are just echoes of your thought processes during the day. And these kinds of dreams are like a videotape being rewound and the most important parts to you being played back, like a review or a recap of your day. So there are no absolutes here, and that is what can make dream interpretation somewhat more complicated, given that not all of them are intuitively triggered, if you will, and a dream can be both symbolic and literal, both kinds of imagery being interwoven. Reverend Douglas has talked extensively about this subject, and materials are available on his website that delve into dream and vision interpretation. Dreams and visions can both come to us through states of deep sleep. A basic way to tell them apart is that visions stay vividly in the conscious mind long after awakening, whereas dreams fade very soon after awakening, necessitating they be written down right away if you wish them recorded accurately. Visions often also contain more literal imagery and can be brought on through meditation practice, whereas dreams are incidental, occurring strictly during sleep. You can also influence what comes to you in a dream. Try this. Just before sleep, focus on getting an answer to a question you have. Say to yourself several times something like the following. I set my intention to receive an answer to your question in my dreams. I will wake up immediately after with the answer fresh in my memory. You may also ask in prayer for an answer to your question to be given to you in a dream. Both methods will set your intention, which is the main goal here. I did this several years ago for a health issue I was dealing with at the time. A few days later, I had a very vivid dream where I was basically told to mix garlic and bladderwort. Now, up to that point, I had never heard of bladderwort and had no idea what it was. So naturally, I googled bladderwort soon after experiencing this dream and was shocked to find out that bladderwort is an actual plant. It apparently is a carnivorous plant and highly unusual to be consumed. I asked Reverend Douglas to interpret the dream, and in an effort to find out what effects garlic and bladderwort have on the body, I asked him about that as well. The reason I created and uploaded this video was to show the kind of information that can come through via the soul mind to the conscious mind during the sleep state. The idea and practice of paying attention to one's dreams is even biblical, so I'd encourage it for any of you who desire to develop your own intuition. To pay attention to your dreams is to focus on and begin to develop your powerful soul mind. A few years ago, while dealing with a health issue, I prayed for a solution to be revealed to me, and a few days later, I had the following vivid dream. Please interpret the same. A girl had a whistle of some sort, and she was standing next to a tree. She blew the whistle, causing birds in the tree branches to react, and one bird started to speak, talking about an herbal treatment of some sort, mentioning garlic and bladderwort. The bird warned to be careful with bladderwort. Please briefly interpret this dream.
The tree would be the tree of knowledge. The birds would represent those thoughts or those minds that would be as to the answer of your question. The herbal remedy was, of course, what you would perceive as the answer to your request for your health issue. And the warning was, of course, not to overdo the bladderwort or take too much of the same. The woman blowing the whistle would be a wake-up or an emergency call. As one would blow a whistle, like a policeman blowing the whistle, it alerts those minds above. Those birds in the branches of the tree would represent those souls or minds that watch over you. The woman would represent the high self, being opposite in gender. And to some degree, it was a signal. It was a wake-up call. It was a awakening, you see. And indeed, the answer would be to your herbal remedy. That you remember, you should apply, you see. However, taking into consideration to take small amounts of the platter, what you'll say. The tree represents the tree of knowledge. It also represents your ability to reach up into the dimensions above, for the tree's crown was large. Again, the birds resting on the same would be the minds that you may contact, or those that watch over you, you'll say. These that are the intermediaries, the angels between heaven and earth, so to speak. Direction.
What effects would consuming garlic and bladderwort have on the body? Please be brief. Thank you.
This would have a tendency to affect the circulatory system or the blood in purifying the same. It will have an attempt to reduce infections that reside in the body or those diseases that hide out in the body. It stimulates the body's eliminating systems, so to speak, taking out of the blood sediments and unwanted bacteria or virus, and ushers it out of the body, a sort of capsulating substance that would take virus that might be live and have it transported out of the body, like a carrier of sorts, you'll say, through the urinary system. Direction.